Hello and welcome. Parametric studies in CFD enables us to quickly set up, run multiple simulations for various conditions, analyze system performance, efficiently optimize our designs, and compare results for several configurations in parallel, thereby saving heavily on computational time. PyFluent Parametric is one of the PyFluent packages that provide Pythonic access to Ansys Fluent's parametric workflow. In this lesson, using an example CFD problem of a static mixer, we will learn how to set up parametric study workflow using PyFluent Parametric package. In this example, we will analyze a 3D mixing tank with fluid entering through two different inlets at different temperatures and exiting through a pressure outlet. We will learn how to define input and output parameters, modify, add, duplicate, or delete a design point. Learn how to create, initialize, update a parametric design point study using PyFluent. Additionally, we will also learn how to generate parametric report, export design point table to a .csv file, and import the file in the Jupyter notebook, and finally, save the parametric project. Without any further delay, let's get started. Let's open a Jupyter notebook. Navigate to the folder which you would like to be your working directory. Please note that simulation files required to demonstrate this workshop need to be in the same folder. Type cmd in the address bar which opens the command prompt in the particular directory and type Jupyter notebook. Now create a new Python notebook as shown. This opens up a Jupyter notebook. Let's now perform the required imports for the parametric study in PyFluent. Import Ansys Fluent Core as PyFluent and from Ansys Fluent Parametric import Parametric Project and Parametric Study. The class Parametric Study is for managing parametric studies and their respective design points. Now launch Ansys Fluent in 3D with double precision. Use code show GUI equal to true to open Ansys Fluent GUI. Then load the provided case file. To read the case file, use this code solver-session.file.readcase and enter the file name staticmixer.case.h5. This picks the file from the working folder. The case file is now loaded. Let's retain all the settings as is and set the number of iterations to 650. For that, type solver-session.tui.solve.set.number-of-iterations to 650. Next step is to create input and output parameters. In this example, the temperature and velocity at two inlets of the static mixer are the input parameters. Enable parameter creation in the TUI and then create input parameters for velocity and temperatures of velocity inlet 1 and 2. Velocity at velocity inlet 1 is set to 1 meter per second and name the input parameter as velocity inlet 1 well. Then set temperature to 300 Kelvin and name it velocity inlet 1 temp. Similarly, set velocity at velocity inlet 2 to 1 meter per second and name it velocity inlet 2 well. Then set temperature to 300 Kelvin and name it velocity inlet 2 temp. Let's define surface report definition to monitor the average temperature and the average velocity at the outlet as output parameters. Create output parameters named outlet temp average and outlet well average using report definitions. To create report definitions, enter solver-session.solution.report-definitions. Click tab and select surface from the list. Then select create and enter name, let's say pressure outlet temp average, within the round brackets and execute code. We see that the report definition is created. Now, to know the available functions, copy-paste the above code in the new cell with the report definition name enclosed in the square brackets since this is not a function. Add round brackets and execute code. The list gives an idea of available functions that are to be defined. With this, let's set the report type to area-weighted average, field to temperature, and select the pressure outlet surface to monitor the average temperature. Similarly, we will create another surface report definition named pressure outlet velocity average to monitor the average velocity at the outlet. Now, initialize a parametric design point study and define it as study 1. The parametric study brings up the table that contains the baseline design point. Once, after initializing the parametric study, we can add design points to our initial case, access current design points defined for the parametric study, monitor job submission settings where we can control how parametric runs are processed, and finally monitor the status of various parametric solutions. Let's access and modify the input parameters of the base design point. Change the velocity for velocity inlet 1 to 0.5 meters per second and update the current design point. Now, let's add a design point under the parametric study. For example, DP1 with inlet 1 temperature set to 500 Kelvin and velocity to 1 meter per second at both the inlets. Now duplicate DP1 to create DP2. Similarly, we can add any number of design points. Let's now update all the design points for study 1. As the design points are updated, we can monitor and view the status in the design point table. We see that for each new inlet velocity and temperature, new values for output parameters are calculated. The solution is converged and the status is updated. Now that the analysis is complete, we can generate simulation reports using the code shown here, where the results from all design points can be analyzed simultaneously. Once the parametric report is generated, we can compare the mesh, contours, vector, and much more. We can also export the design point table to a CSV file. Use the code study1.exportDesignTable and enter the file name. The exported file can be found in the working directory. To import and display this in the Jupyter notebook, use import pandas as PD. This open source library provides various data structures and operations for manipulating numerical data and time series. Now read .csv file and call data frame. It is also possible to delete a design point. For example, to delete DP1, use the code study1.deleteDesignPoints, that is design point 1. We can also create another parametric study by duplicating the current one. Let's create study 2 by duplicating study 1. For that, type study 2 equal to study1.duplicate and rename study 2 as new study. Now let's save the parametric project using the code solversession.tui.file.parametric-project-save-as and enter the path where the project needs to be saved. Close ANSYS Fluent by typing solversession.exit. For detailed information on PyFluent parametric, API references, user guide, and examples, you can refer the PyFluent parametric documentation. To summarize, we briefly discussed about parametric studies in CFD. We learned how to set up parametric study workflow using PyFluent parametric package. We specifically looked at how to define input and output parameters, modify, add, duplicate, or delete a design point, how to create, initialize, update a parametric design point study. Lastly, we learned how to generate parametric report, export design point table, and save parametric project. With that, let's wrap it up.